for Juvenile Justice National Youth Committee, and I am joining the campaign this week as the National Press Secretary. Before we bring the man of the hour out tonight, we have a few speakers. And I want to chat with y'all for a bit. Is that okay?
And ladies and gentlemen, Bernie Sanders is that brother. streets of New York at the Great Climate March. He stands with us to fiercely oppose the XL pipeline. He stands with us to ban fracking now. To stop Arctic oil drilling and to stop all offshore oil drilling. Senator Sanders not only gets it, he's doing something about it. He knows what the fossil fuel industry is trying to do to you and the future of your children and your grandchildren, and he will not stand for it. Another great leader from Vermont, Bill McGibbon, founder of 350.org. Bill says it best, if it's wrong to wreck the climate, it's wrong to profit from it. That's why Bernie Sanders introduced the bill to put a price on carbon. That's just one way to start to get some climate justice for our working class families in frontline communities of color. I'm talking about families who have had so much carbon and pollution shoved down their throats that their children have to get inhalers at 4 years old. That is not right. That's what's happening in Carson, in Wilmington, in Boyle Heights, in Whittier Hills, in South LA, and San Pedro. You can walk out of that building just blocks away to the Allen Coe oil refinery site where EPA officials fainted when they smelled those toxic fumes. Bernie Sanders knows that nobody deserves that. What they deserve is affordable solar on their roofs so that we can eliminate their electric bill. What they deserve is jobs and job training and a pathway to a just transition. There is only one candidate talking about this, only one candidate who is going to spend the money, and that's Bernie Sanders. There is only one candidate who our great allies and friends of the Earth have endorsed because he has proven he is a friend of the Earth and not the rogue and reckless industry trying to destroy it. Ladies and gentlemen, to change everything, we need everyone. And I'm telling you right here, more than anything else, we need Bernie Sanders.
Instead, for the next 10 years,
I became involved in rallies, marches, legislative visits to ensure that all people, even the undocumented, have the right to education and a path to citizenship.
Working people matter. Women's health care matters. Black lives matter. Our children's lives matter. The truth matters. The 1% won't stop until they have all the money and all the power. But we're here tonight with the knowledge that we can build a movement with Bernie. Corporations are not people, and billionaires don't have the power. It's us, it's all of you in this room and across the Los Angeles land. We have the power. We are the people, and we can make it happen. There's one candidate who can't be bought. Bernie Sanders is here to speak the truth. We can build a movement to take back our country and put it in the hands of people. So let's get up. Let's stand up. Stand up for working families. Stand up with the next president of the United States of America, Bernie Sanders.
that Bernie's got a fellow New Englander here tonight, and you may know her too. So right now, I would love for you all to give a warm welcome to actress, writer, and comedian Miss Sarah Silverman.
I just think that is so neat. Bernanke, the next president of the United States,
accomplish. What this campaign is about is bringing people together. Black and white, straight and gay, men and women, native born and immigrant, when we stand together, when we do not allow our opponents to break us up and divide us, when we stand united, we can create a new America. And let me begin by reiterating a point that Simone and others have made, and that is there is no president, none, 1 year after the death of Michael Brown, no president who will fight harder to end institutional racism than our women. Fundamental changes in our criminal justice system. We do not want to be the country on earth that has more people in jail than any other country. The country which has the best educated population. And where our kids, where our young people are in school or at work, not in jail. Sometimes the media asked me, you know, a couple of months ago, they were saying, well, you know, Bernie Sanders, well, you know, he's a kind of a fringe guy. Who believes that, you know, when Bernie talks about taking on the billionaire class, nobody believes that's possible. But all over America, people are saying loudly and clearly that this country belongs to all of us and not a handful of billionaires.